pick in the first annual Best of the Best NFL Draft. Here's the question. If you had the choice to pick anyone, anybody who's ever played in the NFL, who would you take? That's the question we're going to answer tonight. And to help us out, we have in the Stand Cave esteemed football experts, Jeremy Moore and Stan Sigler. Welcome.
Hello.
Hey.
If you guys are ready, we'll start the Best of the Best Drafts.
Let's go.
For the first pick in the Best of the Best Drafts, I'm going to select Ronnie Lott, safety. Absolute. Started out as a cornerback, went to safety, hard hitter, more of a linebacker. Your tight end that you're going to pick, I'm going to cover him. Gronkowski, out of the game. Played one game and pinched his finger and then went to the coach and said, "Coach, I'm going to play." And so they cut off his finger in the game so that he could go in and play again. That's the kind of player I want on my team, Ronnie Lott.
All right, second pick. I have to go with the GOAT. That's right, Jerry Rice. Wide receiver, multiple Super Bowl appearances, and a million receiving yards. So I don't know how you can go with anybody else besides Jerry Rice.
He certainly, with wide receivers, he certainly is the top wide receiver.
Ever?
Yeah.
No way he's even close.
No.
But the problem is now two 49ers have gone. That's not a good thing. Third pick. I am going to start building my offense. I'm going to take Jim Brown. Running back for the Browns. He retired when he was 29, ran for 12,000 yards, 5.2 yards per carry, 106 touchdowns. I mean, he played in a time, I mean, his numbers are still comparable to everybody today. So, you can't beat Jim Brown.
Had 1,500 yards as a running back before it was even popular
yes.
to have 1,500 yards.
And coming back your way, my second pick is going to be cornerback Deion Sanders. Shut down corner, he's going to take care of that side of the field. I don't care if he's guarding Jerry Rice, he's going to shut him down. We've already seen that happen before. And I'm taking him as a Cowboy, not a 49er.
Not only defense, but special teams and offense.
And baseball.
Oh,
so
I guess if you need an outfielder,
I believe
your guy.
Second punt return ever returned it for a touchdown.
Yeah, I think he actually scored more ways than anybody else in the NFL, too. Or tight. So, yeah.
Good pick.
Thank you. It hasn't been a bad pick yet, but Jeremy's up to the second pick now.
So I'm going to go with another greatest of all time. I'm going to go with Walter Payton.
Oh.
Walter is also a Super Bowl champion. He rushed for 16,000 yards. And I just don't know how you go with anybody besides Sweetness here.
He catches the ball out of the backfield. Good teammate. Makes all his teammates better.
110 touchdowns. I mean, yeah, nothing wrong with Walter Payton. Died way too young.
All right, so it's my pick again. I got Lott in the backfield, and I'm going to need a defensive stopper, and so I'm going to take Reggie White. Defensive end, absolute revolutionized the position. 198 sacks, second all time, just took over games defensively. You know, you talk about Brett Favre for the Packers. It's when they signed Reggie White that they went to the Super Bowl.
He put Green Bay back on the map.
Yeah.
That actually hurts. That's a bummer. I was going to go with Reggie White next.
Well, and I got the next pick. And so I'm going to take cornerback Rod Woodson. Started out with the Steelers. Of course, played multiple positions. 71 interceptions. That puts him third all times with 1,049 tackles, played multiple positions, just like Lott, but started out at the cornerback position. Absolute speedster, can cover any one of the receivers out there. And my pick is Rod Woodson.
Looks like you're trying to build a pretty good defense over there.
Defense wins championships.
Man, with all the defensive players, I think I'm going to be forced to take a defensive player here. But I think I am going to not. I'm going to start start in a different place than Gary. I'm going to go with left tackle Walter Jones.
Ooh.
Got to go with the Seahawk here. Plus, who else are you going to have to guard your blind side? I think that the Walter Hall of Fame player, and I just don't know where else to go.
9-time Pro Bowler, and I know that because he's right on my list. I mean, absolutely, and somebody opened up the holes for Sean Alexander. You know,
yeah.
He didn't do it by himself.
Well, unless he did.
Good pick.
Oh, okay.
You know what I've noticed so far is it's hard to make a bad pick right now. There's a lot of names out there. So with my third pick, I am going to work my linebacker crew and take Lawrence Taylor. Probably the best linebacker out there. So tighten up my defense a little bit.
Are you going to take Lawrence Taylor the Giant or Lawrence Taylor the Criminal?
Well, I'm going to take both.
Oh, okay.
I want the criminal aspect of my defense.
Okay.
The good thing about this draft is you can draft the players, but you don't have to put up with their attitude.
That's right.
Yeah.
You just get their career here.
It's interesting about Taylor is that why I didn't have him on my list is because they said a lot of his sacks were freelance, where he was supposed to drop in coverage, and he saw an opening, and he just went in and got the quarterback.
See, I got Dion in coverage, so he can do that.
Yeah. Go ahead.
I'm going to come back. And I'm going to stick with my defense. And I'm going to take Ed Reed, safety.
Oh. Ed Reed.
Yeah.
Wow.
64 interceptions, tough hitter, played tough back there. I actually had a couple guys higher than him on my list, but I liked the way he plays defense.
Had a 106-yard return and a 107-yard return.
Those are two good returns.
Yeah.
See, I got him and Dion now returning kicks.
Not going to punt it to you. That's for sure.
All right, if you guys are going to stick on defense, I'm going to stay on offense because you guys are leaving a lot of names out there. I'm going to go with my pick here. I'm going to go with good old Joe Cool, Joe Montana.
Oh, I thought Namath.
Oh, okay. No, not Joe Namath. 4-time Super Bowl champion, 3-time Super Bowl MVP, 8 times in the Pro Bowl, 2-time MVP. 40,000 passing yards. I just don't know how you get a better quarterback. So, I'm going with Joe Montana. So, you guys can have your defensive backs, and I'm just going to pick them apart with the two greatest players ever.
Can't go wrong. Joe Montana and Jerry Rice.
I thought it was 3 greatest ever, because you got Walter Payton, too.
I just hate picking 49ers. That's the only thing.
It hurts.
It does.
Yes.
They had a good run there.
It was a long time ago.
I don't think the run's going anymore.
Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and switch to the offensive side of the ball right here. And with my next pick, I'm going to go ahead and take Randy Moss. 15,292 yards, 156 touchdowns, 15.6 yards per reception. Oh, and by the way, on his combine, ran a 4.2540. 6'4". He was Calvin Johnson before there was Calvin Johnson.
And I'm so glad my Cowboys passed on him because of his problems. So my Cowboys don't take a chance on players like that.
And in this draft, you don't have to worry about it.
That's right.
I'll take Randy Moss. I'm going to go ahead and keep with my receivers, but I'm going to go a whole different direction and take Tony Gonzalez, tight end, actually second in receptions all time to Jerry Rice, 1,325, 111 touchdowns, makes him fifth all time in yards, absolutely revolutionized the tight end position. No one's better. Tony Gonzalez is my tight end.
All right, I'm going to switch it up here. I'm going to go with, I'm going to switch to defense since you guys are going to offense. And I'm going with Bruce Smith, the defensive end. Never won a Super Bowl, but... nine-time first team, 80s all-decade team, 90s all-decade team, Hall of Famer, and number retired.
Wow.
Five Bills.
Yeah. Can't go wrong there.
200 sacks.
I'm going
to... One of the keys to the Bills making all those Super Bowls.
For sure. Four in a row.
Yeah.
Pretty incredible.
But still getting there is a giant accomplishment.
Yeah. I'm gonna stick with the defensive end theme here. And I'm going to go with Deacon Jones of the Rams back in the 60s and 70s. The Rams had an incredible defense back then. He was a main part of it.
Deacon Jones, dang you.
Actually, they didn't keep stats back then. But Deacon Jones actually came up with the phrase sack. And they say he had four seasons that he had 20 or more sacks in each of the seasons.
Wow.
And that's a 14-game season, not a 16-game, 17-game one.
Big difference there.
Yeah. Nice pick.
And just to solidify that, the other side of that line, I'm going to take Bob Lilly as a defensive end. He played both defensive end and tackle in his career, and I'm going to put him as my other defensive end. Bob Lilly, I believe, is one of the best of all time. And him and Deacon, yeah, love those guys. And he's a Cowboy.
I had to throw that in there, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
What?
Surprise.
I don't even know what a Cowboy is.
A Cowboy is 11-1.
My pick?
Yeah.
Pick? I'm going to go with linebacker. Linebacker Dick Butkus.
Ooh,
love it.
With this pick. 60s all-decade team, 70s all-decade team, Hall of Famer, over 1,000 tackles in his career. And to throw it in there, 27 fumble recoveries. How's that for
Ooh,
being
wow.
in the right place at the right time?
Great cost a lot of those fumbles, too.
How do you think a guy like Butkus would do in the NFL today?
I wonder if he would be as intense.
With all the rules?
Number one, the rules. And number two, I don't think that they would allow for his ferocity to be not left in check.
Yeah. Yeah. Still fun to watch.
It would be fun to watch.
Great pick. I love the old-time players.
Well, it's my pick, and I'm going to go ahead and go on the defensive side of the ball again, and I'm going to take Derek Thomas, linebacker. And he actually had 7 sacks in the game.
Against the Seahawks.
Or 8 sacks, excuse me. 8 sacks in the game. And then who's the player who's had 7 sacks in the game? That's right, Derek Thomas. Yeah, the just love his play, and he was Lawrence Taylor on a team, and 126.5 sacks, 16th all-time, didn't play very long, and just absolutely revolutionized the position. He's going to get after your quarterback. I'm going to go ahead and go a little bit different now, and I've sized my opponents up, and so I'm going to go ahead and take Larry Allen, guard. 6'2", 6'3", 325 pounds. Somebody opened up those holes for Emmett Smith. It was Larry Allen right in the middle. 11-time Pro Bowler. Just couldn't stop him. Just couldn't stop him. And you can put whoever you want on your defensive line, but I think he's going to open up holes for me.
Larry Allen, all right. Since Deion's off the board, I'm going to go with Redskins cornerback Darryl Green. Played for 20 years, one of the fastest men in the NFL. He played until he's 42 years old.
Wow.
42. So, Darryl Green, he's not the best corner, but I think he's one of the best available at this point, so I'm going to stick with him.
And still probably one of the fastest guys around. 5'9". You think my big receivers are going to step up over him?
Nope.
You're fast enough to keep up with everyone.
He is fast enough.
I'm going to go offense this time. I'm going to go wide receiver Marvin Harrison. Just nice and steady. You know, number 7 all-time receiving yards with 14,580, 1,100 receptions, 128 touchdowns. Nice, solid numbers. Just a solid player.
You think he has those numbers away from Peyton Manning?
Well, I think my quarterback's going to be at least equal to better than Peyton Manning because my quarterback is Tom Brady. One of the few current players I've taken.
That's,
Tom Brady. That's my next pick, yeah. Yep.
Answer the question, I do think he has the numbers even with a average quarterback.
He was good. He was good for sure.
And he wasn't flashy, but he just went out and did the job all the time. And with Tom Brady, I mean, you know, you spouted Joe Montana stats, 4 Super Bowls. Tom Brady, 4 Super Bowls. Tom Brady has done it with just a mixture of receivers. They throw guys in. I'm not a New England fan at all. The only time I rooted for New England was the Super Bowl a couple years ago. But it's just Tom Brady, one of the best of all time.
You know, here's a stat for Tom Brady that I like. Most wins by a quarterback, Tom Brady.
Yes.
He's a winner.
Yep.
Like him, don't like him, he's going to go and win for you.
They're frustrating because they win every single year.
I just hope that they're able to put a big fat asterisk next to his Hall of Fame entry, just like Barry Bonds or one of those other cheaters.
Mark McGwire.
Yeah, Mark McGwire, yep.
Russell Wilson.
I don't know about that. All right, so my next pick, I'm going to go with another player, not flashy, not the fastest, but maybe one of the best receivers of all time. I'm going to Steve Largent.
Whoa, I like that one.
Call me a homer, but Steve Largent, like I said, is not the fastest guy on the team. He's not the tallest. He's not the biggest, but still managed 800 career receptions, 819, and 13,000 receiving yards.
16 yards per catch, which is nowadays is high. And that's for a guy with no speed. He was always open, though.
No speed, and your quarterbacks, Jim Zorn, throwing it to you.
Dave Craig. Yep.
And Largent put one of the hardest hits I've ever seen on, was that Atwater for Denver?
Yes.
Yeah. One of the best hits of all time.
We were talking before about if receivers make quarterbacks or quarterbacks make receivers, and Steve Largent made his quarterback.
He made him better. Yep.
Well, this is the last pick in this round. So the 8th pick, And, of course, you're going to want to comment below with who you would pick. That's the fun of this, who you would pick, and just comment below. And for my last pick, I'm going to go ahead and take someone who's actually not on my list. But I'm going to go ahead and take Calvin Johnson, receiver. He was Randy Moss after Randy Moss. And I know, he wasn't even on my list, but just absolutely incredible. And he was one who made his quarterback. Matt Stafford, sometimes he makes completions with his eyes closed. And Calvin Johnson, triple coverage, throw the ball up, and Calvin comes down with it.
I'm over here shaking my head because you and I have had this conversation multiple times, and you don't even think that he'll make the Hall of Fame.
But
you're going to take Calvin Johnson in round number 8 of the greatest of all time.
Greatest of all time.
I think you need to explain to our viewers here.
6'5", 235, 4'3", speed.
Still
what
not
can
good
you
enough
do?
For the Hall of Fame.
What
though.
Can you do? No, not good enough for the Hall of
but
Fame.
But he's good enough to make the top 8 here?
Because who are you going to have guard him? Darryl Green?
Do we need to go down the list of possible contenders?
Yeah. We'll do that in the next video. Comment below, and we'll continue with the best of the best draft.